I lost my mind. I banged a table and kicked a briefcase and slammed out of the room and just felt like this system, I knew it was restricted and I knew it wasn't fair, but what we saw today is just, it was disgusting. He doesn't have the courage to come look at me in the eye and tell me this is why I did 211. I shouldn't serve one inning.
Ladies and gentlemen, that A-Rod comment from Mike Frances, Mike Frances's radio show on WFAN here in New York. We're joined right now by our friend George Vesey, sports columnist, best-selling author at the New York Times. Hello, George.
Steve, how are you doing?
I am fine. Thank you for taking the time.
You're
I appreciate it.
Keeping up on A-Rod?
I am keeping up on A-Rod.
One of the prayer meetings?
No, yeah, well, I was going to bring that up. Of course, there was a Hispanic or Latino group held a prayer vigil outside the arbitration hearings today in New York City for A-Rod, which is so bizarre. I don't know where to start.
Well, I guess you could start with A-Rod's lawyers. I would guess that the prayer meeting outside the baseball headquarters, outside the hearing, are probably just as orchestrated as A-Rod storming out on Wednesday. He's not going to do that if his lawyer hasn't approved it. I think A-Rod is a pretty cunning guy. I don't think he does things. He does things that are stupid, but I don't think he does things that are impulsive. When it comes down to this, he does have a sense of what his side needs to do. And I'm sure the lawyer said, Alex, great idea. Throw a tantrum. Go home and see your kids. You don't need to be here. It's good theater. Get some people on your side.
Well, he didn't go home to see his kids. He went home to see Mike Francesa.
Well, yeah, while he was waiting for, the same thing.
Right, orchestrated. But now, interesting that Francesa asked him, you know, we have the cup, but for time's sake, did you ever do performance-enhancing drugs? You ever do steroids? You ever cheat? You ever, but no. Now, he's not under oath, so he could say what he wants, and he lied to Katie Couric, I believe. So, you know, that is that meaningless, or was there any ground made there or broken there?
Well, I think it's significant. I mean, Mike's a big-time guy, and I can understand why A-Rod would go there to get his story out in the best sports venue, talk radio, on a station. So I can see him doing that. But on the other hand, he ultimately is in the law and the profession that he's in, the rules that he's been playing by. He can sue baseball if he wants, and baseball never likes to see that. But I do think that they've got something on them, whether it's worth 211 or 162 or you know what their fallback position might be. Is he just doing that? Is he figuring that a half a season is still half a lot of money?
A-Rod says that they have no evidence on him. Right. The only evidence they have is the word of the gentleman who ran the center. Pendant evidence, or they're just taking the word of a guy who at first refused to cooperate, who himself is in trouble, and reportedly got paid by Major League Baseball to cooperate.
Well, I wouldn't know. I'm not close to it. I mean, obviously, I haven't been working as much. I retired full time a couple of years ago, so I'm not looking at the details, and I don't know if anybody knows that. But from the outside, these are all pretty seamy characters. It seems to me A-Rod's been in on this stuff from early on, that he was using things. If he suddenly stopped, if he was using it back during the research period, that he was able to limit it, to say, well, I only did it, but I didn't inhale, as somebody once said. You know, if he's doing that, but now he's able to parse it by saying, but you know, once they started testing, I never did anything, I'm clean. I don't believe him. Whether I believe the other people or not is, I don't know.
What about the commissioner? I mean, I have heard that it's never been done before for any of these arbitration hearings regarding substance abuse or banned substance abuse, whatever. Since they've had the collective bargaining agreement address that the commissioner has never been required or never come to the hearings to testify. Do you believe that since this is a much longer suspension than any other previous suspension that's being proposed, do you believe that A-Rod has the quote-unquote right to have his accuser confront him or confront his accuser in that setting?
In that setting, no, not at all. I don't. It's not written down anywhere. It's not part of the procedure. Baseball has its legal angle, and whether he wants to accept it or not. I mean, baseball has always done its very best to keep everything in-house, not to get it out into the courts, because they don't want that. They don't want the court looking at the reserve clause or other little goodies that baseball has gotten away with over the years. So they cower at the idea of things getting out. And I don't blame them for that, because you like to keep things in-house. So A-Rod and his lawyers are not stupid. They know that if you threaten baseball with that, maybe you get half a year knocked off or what. But that's what they're trying to do. It's intimidation both ways.
Yeah, no, very interesting. And, of course, we're all watching Robinson Cano. You think anybody's going to give him 10 years at $310 million?
No, I think that Tyler Kepner's column had a good point today. That why would you think that his next 8 or 9 or 10 years will be as good as his first 8 or 9 or 10 years? There's no reason to think. You know, one thing I was thinking about.
We only got 30 seconds, but okay. Go ahead.
I just want to say that Bud Selig probably shouldn't take it too personally and get too involved. I don't know that he does. I just remember Bart Giamatti taking it very personally with Pete Rose.
Yeah, sure.
And there's no point in that. You know, it's in the end of the day, it's your job to get the truth out, but you can't take it personally when somebody stonewalls you.
The great George Vesey, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, sir, for your time. Appreciate
it. Always a pleasure, Steve.
Thank you. George Vesey, sports columnist and author, great author. And anyway, we'll talk to him again soon on the Steve Malzberg.